despite the brutal heat, some still ventured out to enjoy some weekend events like the Clinton Grand Prix. That's where News 10's Richard Solomon continues our team coverage tonight. He has more on how people are staying vigilant.
The sun is scorching down here on the Grand Prix. I'm drenched in sweat just standing here. But many folks in Clinton aren't letting the heat of the day ruin their weekend.
Nothing could keep Cameron Parr off the track Saturday. He's one of the many drivers at the annual Clinton Grand Prix.
You know, the speeds with the track, the different ways the streets are, it's a challenging experience.
The city of Clinton has been turned into a racetrack, but the drivers are facing another challenge, the deadly heat.
When you're out on the track, you know, it might be 115 degrees by yourself, but when you're out here and you're also battling the heat out here, it's hard to stay cool.
It can get very dangerous.
Brenda Vorick is a paramedic. Many first responders are on high alert because of the heat wave sweeping the Wabash Valley.
There is a cooling tent. It's pretty cold in there. It's nice. And then we're here to kind of check for signs of heat stroke, heat exhaustion, the difference in that, and keep everyone safe.
Some fans stayed in the shade with lots of water and wet towels. Chris Hicks wasn't going to let the insane heat ruin his family weekend.
We've been asking for this summer weather, and you know, I'm excited to be here. It's going to be a fun day.
But Parr knows exactly how he'll be spending the rest of his Saturday.
Once I get done today, I'm going to get in the AC because it's way too hot for me.
If you miss Saturday's Grand Prix, there will be another one Sunday. It starts at 12 p.m. Reporting in Clinton, Richard Solomon, News 10.